just saw her crying, and I felt that I knew why she was crying. Oh. Instead of the celebration that we were having, I felt her crying, and I felt her lonely, and I could see it. You know, this is what it is. I see it in people. I sense it. I become the person. I guess at that time I couldn't interpret it because I was only five, so I would only say it. Mm-hmm. Now today I would deal with that differently. Of course I would give the same response, but I would look at it differently, and I would prepare the person differently. I wouldn't do it in the sense that I did at that time. But it's been a part of my life. And let me explain, this is not something that people should feel it's a wonderful thing to have, because it isn't. Mm-hmm. First of all, people question me, people doubt me. And then I suffer things before it's time to suffer, and I laugh before it's time to laugh. Nothing in my life, nothing surprises me anymore. And it's prepared me to not be able to accept life the way I would want it, but the way it is. Mm-hmm. So it could be difficult.
Yeah, maybe God arranged everything.
That's right. Yes. He always does.
Yes. 好，我们要休息一下，进段广告，马上回来。
各位观众朋友，大家好，我是大A学习基金会郑少颖，
我是梁婉梅，
我是李金芬，
别忘了收看《弯曲
夜生活》。
亲爱的观众朋友您好，欢迎您继续回到我们的节目，我是丁卫平。今天呢，我们为您请到的是心灵大师Elizabeth 来给我们分享了她自己的故事，而且呢也为大家介绍这本书，就是隐藏的真相啊。刚才我们讲到的这个，她有提到她从小就有这种能力啊，就是能够预知未来啊，能够去看到一些就是过去和现在还有将来要发生的事情，但实际上她这种能力呢是与生俱来的，他自己也没有办法解释，而且他自己呢在其中也有很多的痛苦的挣扎。那么他在十几年的时间呢多次去台湾，可以说他对台湾对中国大陆呢有一份特殊的感情啊。那在他自己的一首诗中，他写到呢，我要借此机会感谢台湾的人民，你们的温暖，你们温暖的拥抱我，欢迎我，你们以欢笑慈爱鼓励我，你们信任相信我是送给我最好的礼物，我也同样相信你们，我相信你们坚毅不拔，你们挺过无数的风暴，我也相信你们充沛的力量。 So I mentioned about your poem.
Yeah.
Yes, to Taiwan.
Oh.
So how did this connections build up?
My relationship with Asia has been, I guess since my past life, my relationship with Taiwan has been for 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very close relationship that I feel has come with me for a long way. And it's a relationship that I think will be in my life forever.
Yes. So you said your pre-life.
Yes.
Maybe you're Chinese.
Yes.
How do you know that?
and the question here is not maybe, it's for sure that
for
I
sure,
have
For sure, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And let me explain. After going to Taiwan mm-hmm. for several, maybe two or three trips, I gave a very big session at the Chiang Kai-shek Memorial Hall, and I did as best as I could to help as many people, and I know that they felt it. When I came back, they wanted to see me again, and Taiwan offered me, Elizabeth, what you have done so much for Taiwan, what can Taiwan do for you?
Yeah.
And I said, well, I would like to take a visit to China.
Yeah, have you ever been to China?
At that time, it was 12 years ago, my first trip.
Okay.
After that, it's been so many times. And when I got there, I just sensed, as soon as I get there, 12 years ago when I got out of the airport in Beijing, I sensed that I was in a place I had been before.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt home. I felt at home.
So you said your pre-life is a Chinese. So
yes.
Which part from China? Do you know that?
Oh, I know that I was a man. And
oh.
I know I lived in a mountain.
Oh.
And that I was a teacher. That I know because I physically has seen myself there.
Mm-hmm.
So I lived in a mountain. And I know I had everything that I needed because I had a very large tree to cover me from the heat and the sun. And I have plenty of water, and I always had people that would come to listen to me speak.
Mm-hmm.
And this is very much like the life I live now, except of course the accommodations are different, but my desire and my intentions are the same. So I know that that was my place, and I keep going back. And I hope someday I'll be able to see that mountain again.
Yeah, I can tell that you are very popular among the Chinese people. So, 他刚刚提到他的前世呢，可能是一位中国人，而且他感觉他是住在中国的一个山上的一个这个男性，而且在这个就是作为一个教化别人或教育别人的一个角色，所以他觉得呢，他跟中国跟台湾有这种非常深的渊源。So, I know that when you are in China, in Taiwan, that people really like you, but in Taiwan, you also predicted that President Ma Ying-jeou could be in the danger, right?
Yes.Mm-hmm. Yes. You see, for all these years, I've never made any political predictions.
Yes.
Because I didn't feel that I wanted to get involved with that, and I felt it wasn't necessary at that time. But because I've been a part of Taiwan for the past 15 years, this time I felt that if for some reason I had to lose my entry back into Taiwan, I was just one person, and I could live...for a while not being there. But I felt that the president, now the president at that time, Mr. Ma, was more important to me and that I had to say what I had to say. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make sure and still want to make sure that he is protected and taken care of and that the security is around him because this is one person that's going to help an entire country. I am just one person that if I'm not allowed back in, it would make a difference to me, but they would always remember me. But so I said what I had to say because this is what I felt and this is still what I feel. I feel that there still needs to be more security and that he needs to still be watching out for himself until all this is over and it's going to take some time.
I can feel that you really have the heart care about him. Why this Mr. Ma Ying-jeou is so important for you?
Because you see, I read people and even though people have to understand, I am of no particular party. Mm-hmm. I don't vote in Taiwan.
Yes, of course.
You see, I vote here in the United States, mm-hmm. but I read people very well. Mm-hmm. And I can read his intentions and mm-hmm. I can read his feelings for the country.
So and what I is can, his intention? Feeling?
His intention is to bring prosperity back into the country, to give people hope and opportunity to restart something mm-hmm. that they feel they have lost. And I also like his communication skills, and I'm hoping that his communication skills will open the door to China and him being able to have a conversation based on peace, tranquility, and the pride of the Asian country.
Yeah, so can you tell the future? If he, yeah.
Well, I certainly believe, because I know at this point, I sense it, and I could feel it. I can certainly feel the prosperity of the country. I can feel the stock exchange and the work opportunity. And I can certainly feel that not only himself, but the people that he's choosing around him are people that are going to work very hard at creating this atmosphere of communication with China. And I know that China has also prospered in a tremendous amount. And what they're also looking for is to have, it's not a unification, it's a unification of ideas and thoughts.It's a unification of people being able to get along with each other and respect each other's values and traditions. So I'm just hoping, because of what I feel, that he stays safe mm-hmm. and all the people around him that have this intention to bring this country back into prosperity and to see the happiness of Taiwan and China and the transportation and the communication between them and the tourism and the brothers and